Coliseum for a return visit for WCW Monday Nitro.
And that's when Hollywood lets the world know that he's running for President of the United States and will announce his running mate.
So that's going to be a very big evening on many counts. So you know,
boy,
that night we're going to give you the best wrestling action. And Brain, I received a phone call today. Our very close friend, Derek Irwin from the American League office, is going to be at ringside at the Nassau Coliseum that night.
Where's Dr. Budig?
Dr. Budig, I believe, is in Japan on tour right now.
This guy is very confusing. I mean, there was a time everybody thought he was a spectacular athlete, albeit just a little bit twisted. But what is it about Raven? I mean, let's use his own words. What about Raven? What has got into this guy of late?
Well, it could be a combination of the flock disbanding. It could be a combination that he has a couple of losses and he can't stand it. And everybody has a down time, you know, in sports. Athletes will go through slumps, and maybe he's in a slump right now.
Well, I get the whole peaks and valleys thing you're talking about, Tony, but we've seen Raven in situations where it actually looked like when he was being beaten, he enjoyed the fact that he was beaten, almost as if the beating he was getting was like he deserved it, like it was some sort of penance or punishment.
Achtung, Achtung, yes, Alex, right.
Mm-hmm. What do you mean, uh-huh?
Shh. Raven, du bist ein kleiner, dreckiger Jammerlappen. Oh. That's right. You're an uneducated American. You only speak one language. Well, I'm gonna make it real simple for you and all those morons out here. I'm gonna speak really slow. Raven, you're the prime example of the American people. You're a dirty, filthy slob. Look at me, I'm clean, I'm shaved, I got abs. Look at you, Raven, you cover yourself with disgusting tattoos. And what's that knot on your forehead? I don't even wanna know. That's all. Why you're sad and depressed. You know what? A little depression wouldn't keep a proud German like Alex Wright. No!
There you go.
Well, the fight's back in Raven now.
I never really agreed for any of Raven's tactics, but I agree with that.
Whoa.
Enough is enough. And Alex Wright had to get out of the ring in a hurry.
That may be the best move of the evening.
I believe so.
Well, what that could have been was the wake-up call to Raven.
Well, that would seem that way, Lee, but look, Raven he's not really giving chase, is he? I mean, it seemed like he was angry at first. But
he's gone back to sitting down.
He's sitting down again. And now Alex Wright. Well, Alex Wright saw this open window and he just stuck his head right through it is what he did. This is so bizarre with Raven. It's almost as if for a fleeting moment, he got a little bit of fire into him and then he just sat right back down.
It's exactly what he did. And you can't do that with somebody like an Alex Wright.
You can't do that in WCW with any of these great athletes. Especially now. I mean, look at it. 60 men. It could be an upset. It could be some guy's only chance of getting a world title shot would be to get an upset through World War III.
Well, you look at Alex Wright. He's the man who's been claiming to be the... All right, Raven with a little comeback here. Firing on Alex Wright now. Now we're going for it. Raven.
Alex putting down Alex. So much agility, and he is boastful, I know, braggadocious, but he can usually back it up, and Raven just stepped right down that time and ducked low. And Alex Wright hit the top rope.
You imagine how successful he'd be, Raven, if he didn't have all this self-pity?
Or didn't have this clown next to him.
Well, that's Lodi who made it to the right of your screen, and now he's still begging Raven to get up, and he still wants...
Wait, yeah. Disco's out.
Yeah, the Dayglo Green. What's Disco? Disco trying to get rid of Lodi here.
Well, that's that sinus infection green.
Is that what that is?
Yes.
And, of course, he and Alex Wright have been tag team partners, but not as of late.
And Disco just dropped Lodi with a big right hand. Oh!
And look,
Canyon's back out.
Canyon came out from out of nowhere, and now Canyon, who decked the Disco Inferno, is going after Alex Wright on the outside. Oh! Alex Wright with a great counter move that time.
Now look, there's about five or six guys out here. What do you think's going to happen when you get 60 guys in three rings?
Baseball slide drop kick by Raven. And look at Alex Wright go. He sends Raven back against the
back to our first original participants, albeit nowhere near the ring.
How about Canyon and Lodi coming out to Raven's aid? Now it was Canyon who was browbeating Raven.
And Disco was out, too.
Yeah, and Disco out. I know for a fact that Disco and Alex Wright have not been teaming that often together into the midsection, but they were back out here to go. They pushed him away.
This is more like the Raven of old.
It was for a minute. Now Raven, obviously the midsection smarting there, or maybe the back, as Raven is wounded. He appears.
Now where's he going?
Well,
look at the knot on his head.
That's what Alex was talking about, and well, he's just slowly, methodically walking away here.
He's not walking away like walking away to get a breather. Guys, he's just flat out walking away.
He's leaving.
I mean, he's walking up the gangway to get out of here.
Goodbye. Done.
Well, it's going to be a count out. Alex Wright gets a win because Raven, even though it was a very physical Raven's rules type match, just walked away from him. It gets more bizarre with Raven. We're coming right back on Thunder.
Oddball.